Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel once again. My name is Nidhi and you're watching my series on how to become a cabin crew. Now, this video is basically part two of the series that I'm making on Gulf Air recruitment. If you still haven't watched the part one, go ahead and do that right now because I've shared as to how you can apply for the recent cabin crew job opportunity. I've shared all the details in terms of the requirements, the recruitment process, and how exactly should you apply. But in this particular video, I want to share in detail the whole interview process because as I said, someone has been really, really kind to share that information with us who has been a successful candidate in the last recruitment, and this person has come forward and shared all the details. So I'm here with all of you to share the details. So without further ado, let's get started. So as I had shared in my previous video, basically the recruitment is not really held by Gulf Air directly. They go through a recruitment agency, which is NECCTI, and they have listed the job opportunity on this website called inflightcrewjobs.com. So once you have applied, basically you just have to wait and watch. But before we go ahead, I just want to congratulate this person for making it all on her own and being able to get this job, and she's thoroughly enjoying herself from what she shared with me. She praises a lot about Gulf Air, so definitely it's a great place to be at. But yes, moving on to the interview process. What this person has shared with me is that she only got the invitation 2 days before the interview. So just be patient if you have applied. It will take some time for them to get back to you. And once they basically send you the invite over the email, they will let you know where exactly do you have to go for the interview. When you go for the interview, you have to carry certain documentations, which will obviously be shared with you in the email. You definitely need to carry your CV, you need to carry your passport, and you have to show them the invitation letter. So this is not a walk-in interview, this is an invite assessment. So you will have to show the invitation letter. So a lot of you have been asking me about whether it's a walk-in interview. It is not a walk-in interview. And after that, you will have to go through height and weight check. The height obviously has been listed as 160 centimeters. The weight has to be in accordance to your height. So basically they will check for your BMI. So go ahead and make sure that your BMI is in the healthy range. You're not under under the healthy range, and you're not over the healthy range as well. If you want to know what I mean by that, go ahead and check out my video on BMI and you will get some information on that. Now, moving on. On that day itself, the first round would be conducted where everyone were asked to stand in one queue, and there was a chit that you have to pick up, and you will be given 30 seconds to basically spontaneously talk on that topic that is being given to you. So the topic could be anything. You basically have to be very, very spontaneous. Whatever topic is given to you, this round is all about checking your spontaneity, checking your confidence, checking your personality, how you're basically able to just speak your mind if you're asked a question very, very impromptu. So that's what this round is all about, guys. So don't get nervous. It doesn't really matter if you're not able to come up with some grand answers, because that's what I always say. That's not what they're looking for. They're looking for your spontaneity. They're looking for your personality. They're looking for your charm. They're looking for your confidence. So go ahead and nail that first round using all these tips that I'm sharing with you right now. So basically, if you go through this first round, you will be called the next day for the second round of interview. First and foremost is checking your scars. So they will go ahead and check for tattoos, scars, piercings. So again, as I said, you basically have to ensure that whichever part of your body would be visible when you wear the uniform, there should be not a lot of scarring there. There should not be tattoos and piercings and things like that. That is what you have to take note of. After that, there is a written test. Now, for most airlines, especially Middle Eastern ones, they basically follow the test which is called the IELTS, which I'm again linking it up for you guys, which is basically an English test. You can actually take it on your own as well to understand what the test is all about. And once you clear the test, then there will be group discussion. This group discussion basically is like a normal group discussion where you will be given a topic and you basically have to discuss, and then you have to present. So that is what the group discussion is all about. And once the group discussion is done, you will have to go through the 101 interview. The 101 interview is again exactly the same as what I've been talking about any other airline. They would want to know why you want to become a cabin crew, what is it in you that would make you a suitable candidate to become a cabin crew with their airline. They would want to know your weakness, your strength. They would want to know what exactly are the skills of a cabin crew. They would definitely want to know if you have any work experience and what have you learned in your work experience. If you're a fresher, they would like to know what motivates you to becoming a cabin crew. So these are some of the standard questions that most airlines would ask you. I have made a video on these questions trying to share with you guys what exactly the interviewers are looking for when you're answering these questions. So I'm linking up that as well in this video here for you. Go ahead and do watch those videos. So yeah, basically that is what the 101 interview entails. And then the next day you have to do a swimming test, which is 50 meters unaided. So basically that is why I was telling you that you need to know swimming. If you watch my first part of this video series, I've talked about why swimming is also one of the requirements. So having said that, once you go through the entire interview process, basically this recruitment agency, you have to pay them a sum of money, and this money is not refundable. This money is basically the money that is taken by this recruitment agency, and this is not fake. This is the process, and this is the money that you need to pay to them, and basically they will ask you to sign a contract with Gulf Air to become a cabin crew with Gulf Air. So you can take it as training money, you can take it as agency money, or whatever money that you would like to take it as, but this is the money that you need to pay to MECCTI once you basically clear all the relevant rounds. So another thing that you want to take note of would be the medicals. You know, Qatar Airways and Emirates also do these medicals. This is basically for Middle Eastern Airlines. This is a visa regulation that you have to go through GAMCA test. I'm basically putting it up on the screen for you so you would know what are some of the tests that you would need to go through. And this is the medical test that you would need to go through for Gulf as well. The good news here is that for any reason that you don't clear the medicals, they will return the money to you. This is what has been shared with me. So basically you don't have to worry that your money would be taken and it would not return to you just in case you don't clear the medicals. So it's a very, very transparent process, and this is exactly how it is. And you basically would be signing a contract with them. So this is something that will be based on what the Gulf Air wants to sign, 1 year, 2 years, and how exactly the bond is going to be and things like that. So this is something which is very, very company specific. So yes, this is the whole interview process for Gulf Air, and all the best to the ones who are basically applying for it. I've tried to get as much information as I always do for all of you, and of course do subscribe to my channel, do press the notification bell for more video updates, so you would know when the next video gets released. As I said, I try my best, but at the end of the day I would have to thank all of you for all the information that you share. So do like, share and comment in this video. If there's any information that I've missed out, do put it down there as well. I'll be happy to have that on my YouTube, and do follow me on Instagram and Facebook as well to connect with me there, and reach out to me on my website if you'd like to know any of the coaching details. And in the meantime, as I always say, stay pretty, stay handsome, and I love you guys.